Unfortunately, this year we were not able to perform our junior production live. However, that did not stop us from rehearsing and putting together an amazing show for all of you at home. There will be singing and dancing by our year 1 to 4 classes, as well as some stellar performances by our main cast. Now sit back and relax as we embark on this journey around the world with our story of the Button Box.
Thank you. There's all kinds of things for you to do. There's games and there's paints and
my balls.
Snakes and ladders, Ludo, or things to glue. There's dollies and jigsaws.
My balls.
Yes, you were, though he was your great-great-uncle. He was really great. Double great.
Granddad, your jokes are so bad.
Hey, look, this was Uncle Jack.
That's not a button. It's a pebble.
No, but Jack was going to make it into a button. He never did, obviously. It's got little dots painted on it.
It's an Aboriginal painting from Australia.
Australia?
He got it when he visited Ayers Rock.
Nowadays, Grandad, Ayers Rock is called Uluru.
Really? How come?
Because that is its proper name.
Anyway, Jack was very interested in Aboriginal people, particularly in their story of how the world began.
Thank you. message in that story, Alex.
What message?
Boasting is bad.
I never boast.
Not much.
Now then, Jack, you know Alice never boasts.
It's okay, Grandad. I just ignore him. There are some lovely shiny sequins in here.
Are they for your pajamas, Grandad?
I don't think they'd go with what Grandad wears to bed.
Look at this one, Jack.
It's got some kind of pattern scratch on it. Look, Grandma.
It's a bit of scrimshaw.
Scrimshaw?
Yes, it's a type of carving that sailors use to do on seashells to pass the time. But this one is carved into a coconut shell.
He probably brought it back from Jamaica. There's a scrimshaw button in there somewhere. Pass it over. I'll see if I can find it.
Made out of?
It's been carved out of some type of hard wood.
Yes, it's made out of a chestnut tree. There are lots of chestnut trees in Japan, as well as the wood being a great building material, and firewood. Chestnuts are delicious to eat as well. Food. So the elephant that came from must have died at least 100 years ago.
Does that make it all right then?
Dunno. Do you think it's worth loads of money now that ivory is so real?
Ooh, we could sell it.
I don't think it's legal to sell ivory anymore.
We wouldn't sell it anyway. It's part of our family history. How come? It was given to Uncle Jack by Nathaniel Wartokie Smythe, some kind of distant cousin.
Was it an explorer, like Uncle Jack?
No, he was an anth. Anth something-ologist?
Anthropologist. He studied the people of Serengeti.
What did he discover?
Among other things, that they're fantastic musicians. He used to write down their songs and rhythms while children played all around.
a turtle, but it's wrong to sell turtle shell now.
Like the elephant, many turtles are endangered.
It's another old button that Jack picked up in his travels long ago.
This one's Samoa, I think. Uncle Jack loved visiting the Pacific Islands when he was in the Navy.
That one, it's from the East India Company. Uncle Jack got it when he visited Bombay.
Bombay's called Mumbai now, Granddad.
Oh, never mind, let's just focus on Uncle Jack's visit to Bombay, which is what it was called back then.
Where we sailing to old Bombay? Couldn't wait
shopping.
All day long.
Even better.
Why don't you tell them about this one, dear? Gerald, why do we bother buying anything healthy?
Granddad, can you tell us about the button?
Let me see. It looks like it's made out of amber. I wonder where it came from.
A long time ago, people from Korea sometimes wore buttons made of amber, jade, or turquoise. Uncle Jack once visited Korea and heard some children sing a song about butterflies. Butterflies are a symbol of happiness in Korea.
Oh, I love butterflies.
Thank you.
can though, leprechauns.
But you don't have to see things for them to be real. I've never seen the North Pole before, but that doesn't mean it's not there.
You can see the North Pole on TV though.
Well, you can't see a broken heart, but it feels real.
Gerald, you've gone all poetic and sad on us.
Granddad's got a point. Invisible things can be real. Now I'm starting to think I know where this button's from.
Yes, I'm sure you do. Although Uncle Jack and other members of our family travelled all around the world, they still returned home to New Zealand.
There's no place like home after all. Lucky, it's nearly bedtime.
Oh no!
story?
Please.
No. You can dream up your own story. Step down.